一番大変なのは寒かったことですかね。冬のモントリオールだったんで、スタジオから一歩出るとマイナス15度とかなんで、もう凍りつくんですよね。で、下がもう凍ってて歩けないみたいな感じのところで、だから何でしょう、ローランドさんも結構ロケのところはあれすごいなと思うんだけど、台本では別に普通に晴れた日とかそうなんですけども、雪がじゃがじゃが降っててももう気にしないで撮るんですね。日本の人がこれを見たらどういうふうな感想を持つかなっていうのは正直いろいろ思うところはあります。それは脚本を読んで、ただそれぞれの感じ方っていろいろ違うと思うし、まず何よりもやっぱこの映画はきちっとやっぱりその戦争っていうものがどういうものなのかっていうのをやっぱりその人種を超えて描こうとしているところがあると思うので、その勝つ負けるであったり、人が死ぬ生きるっていうことであったりっていうことを、なんて言うんでしょう、こう大げさにならずでもきちっと伝えてる感じがあるので、それなんかすごく品が良くて、そういうのは多分日本のお客さんもちゃんとなんか伝わってくれるんじゃないかなとは思いますけど。
Initially, the first thing when I saw the script, I saw Roland Emmerich, and I was like, oh wow, you know, I grew up with Roland's movies. You know, to work with this cast, you know, this incredible ensemble cast, and learn from them as actors, you know, to be able to come to Hawaii and have this kind of access and film on Ford Island, you know, and then you read this script and you see this.Incredible story, this incredible arc, this incredible emotional narrative, you know, it really was the dream role and the dream project. And in its reality, it really was that.
I mean, I knew about it as a kid, briefly, but my family was Navy, so that was a huge initial draw, but also just the story itself, the characters, the writing, the script, everybody that was involved. I found out he was cast. I was really upset about that. and when we first met, you know, we hit it off. And I was like, you know what, this is going to be a great experience. And I'm so happy to be a part of it.
I mean, I'd say the wind machines were the hardest thing to deal with. You know, we had these industrial wind machines that were kind of pretending that they were the wind from the Pacific Ocean. And it was like, you know, we were standing next to each other. We couldn't hear each other.
Yeah. And after every take, after the wind machines would shut off, we'd have to go into a private room.To re-record the lines because, you know, you couldn't really hear that well. So recreating that was kind of difficult.
Kind of disjointed
in
a way. Yeah, it was a challenge, but it was also fun.
Yeah, we had a great time.
Yeah,
we were
we
like in a
challenge.
Hurricane. We were just, you know, we were flying.
I, you know, like Roosevelt said, I hate war. And war, you know, I don't think war needs to be glorified at all in motion pictures, but to honor and glorify those who did fight for our respective countries on both sides. I think that's how, that's how people come together, Japan and the United States are, you know, now best friends in this world. United States and Vietnam are friends in this world now. So it's incredible how things change, isn't it?
I remember nothing, but I loved learning it. I love that the movie opens in Japan. The Japanese part of this movie is so important. The Japanese actors in the film are wonderful. Some of the most moving scenes to me were the Japanese side. But yeah, it was such a thrill. Honestly, when I saw in the script that I could speak Japanese, I got so excited because you don't get that opportunity a lot to speak another language in a movie. And then all of a sudden, you...have such respect for people that are not acting in their native tongue. Like, I just felt like, oh my gosh.
Boku wa kitanda toro mura aimichita kokoro wa.
Ima, akasareru, Nihon no unmei o kaeta mikkakan.
The Japanese are planning something bigger. We believe it's Midway.
Ore tachi wa mamori tousu to chikatta.
Nihon, soshite.アメリカ、彼らの勝敗を分けたのは何か。ミッドウェイ。